So, I haven't made a video in like 7 months, and coincidentally, 7 months ago, Star Wars: The Last Jedi released in theaters. Now, I don't mean to say that the release of The Last Jedi sent me into a depressive spiral. At least, I don't think it did. I just think something in this movie might have legitimately broken me without me knowing it. I think it broke a lot of people. And I mean, that's kind of apparent. You're probably sick to death about hearing of The Last Jedi and all of its failures. But I have to make this video. I have to do this for me because ever since the release of The Last Jedi, I've just felt so creatively drained, and I have to think it played some part in that. You see, my channel is sort of focused around media, video games, and sometimes movies. Now, video games had been disappointing me for a very long time before The Last Jedi, but I don't know, The Last Jedi was sort of just the nail in the coffin for me. I didn't want to talk about media anymore. I was just kind of done. Recently, there have been some things to come out that have sort of sparked a resurgence in my passion for media. And now that I have some of my passion back, I want to go in depth about why The Last Jedi, I guess, had such a strange impact on me. So, segueing into the main topic of this video, I think what's made this problem with The Last Jedi even worse for me is the fact that I've been trying for the last few months to convince myself that the movie was good. And as a whole, it just wasn't. Like most, after this episode 7, I wanted to see the franchise branch off in new directions and stop playing things so safe. We wanted more than just a retreading of the original trilogy. Give us something new. I was looking forward to episode 8 to really prove itself by being different and breaking Star Wars conventions. And my biggest problem, and the one that's been the hardest to come to grips with, is that episode 8, on paper, executed exactly the things that I wanted to see done. It was different, it did break Star Wars conventions, but ultimately, it did so in a completely horrific manner that leaves episode 9 painted into a corner. So first I'm going to talk about the things that I wanted to see that this movie actually delivered on. I had a list of things that I wanted to see. As a fan of the Knights of the Old Republic video game series, I really like the lines between heroes and villains being blurred. I wanted to see the black and white morality of Star Wars be challenged in an interesting way. And with the Luke, Rey, and Kylo dynamic, I kind of got that delivered to me. I got pretty much exactly what I wanted, and frankly, I really enjoyed it. I felt that Mark Hamill and Daisy Ridley really played well off each other. The second thing that I wanted to see was the Force be used in new and interesting ways. After watching Rogue One, where Vader uses the Force in such a cool way, he lifts someone up, he slices him in half, I don't know, I wanted it to be turned up even further. I wanted to see people ripped in half with the Force. Okay, well, maybe that's a bit too graphic for a Disney movie, but I didn't get such violent use of the Force, but the Force was used in a new and interesting way. The ending with Luke's astral projection was kind of the exact thing that I wanted to see as well. People thought it was dumb, but really, I mean, Luke was just making a Force ghost of himself. That's not really too dumb for me. And I thought it did a good job of making Luke Skywalker into the legend that we sort of imagined him being. In the end, he was completely vindicated. However, keep in mind, with Luke Skywalker, I'd almost be willing to accept him to actually start fighting the walkers with a lightsaber in hand in a spectacular showing of Force powers, but that's just me. Now, the final thing that I wanted to see in this movie was a twist. Specifically, walking into this movie, I had a specific twist in mind, and that was that I wanted to see Kylo and Rey team up against Snoke, and I wanted them to kick his ass. I wanted Snoke dead so desperately. He was probably the most pointless character in episode 7. He was such a cynical by the numbers, I'm a bad guy, that I wanted him dead so bad, and the movie did exactly what I wanted to see. Snoke went out like a total bitch. I know some people are like, oh, I wanted to know more about Snoke, but I don't think you did, and I don't think you know what's best for you. The channel I Hate Everything did a video on this where he talked about J.J. Abrams, director of Episode 7, and his obsession with the cinematic mystery box, meaning that Abrams loves creating mystery not to necessarily deliver any meaningful payoff, but just to make people ask questions. Snoke wasn't designed as an interesting character with an interesting backstory. That's the thing people fail to accept. He was designed as a question mark, a cynical, lazy, question mark to be filled in at another date. The Last Jedi fully embraced and admits his utter pointlessness to the audience in a respectful display, and I could not applaud them more for it. So The Last Jedi really checked a lot of boxes off for me that I wanted to see in a Star Wars movie. Everything that can make Star Wars a truly thinking type of action film was in the movie. So walking out of the theater, I was sort of satisfied. There's just one problem. The elements that I've described are only part of the movie. There's still a whole nother half, maybe even two-thirds of this thing, that I haven't talked about. To be honest, I've tried to repress it. You see, I think most people can agree that the things that I've mentioned were legitimately brilliant ideas, or at the very least, were worth attempting, and showed a side of Star Wars that we desperately needed to see. If this movie was just focused on those elements, it would be pretty damn good. Maybe a little depressing and maybe a little bit pointless, but still good. But the rest of this movie doesn't focus on those elements. Instead, it takes those elements and drags them through lava. You want to see the black and white morality of Star Wars be thrown into question? How about a side story casino planet with a character who spews platitudes about how slavery is bad, with a weird animal rights message tacked on? How about instead of a good guy who's legitimately motivated to do the wrong thing, we just have an idiot who doesn't want to share their plan? See, Poe wouldn't have done the things that he did if Holdo had just, like, told him her plan, but she didn't. So instead of having two different perspectives clashing with one another, and one being proven wrong, we have one party that's correct and just withholding information, and one party that's acting as anyone would without said information. It's moronic. Oh! And how about characters who are the equivalent of Saturday morning cartoons? Quick tangent here, fuck all of these villains. Look, I know Star Wars villains aren't exactly subtle. In fact, they're downright silly, but there's always such a commitment, such a level of intimidation from them, that you don't really care how silly they are. They're good villains. General fucking Grievous is one of the most ridiculous villains in all of Star Wars, but the movie itself commits to him also being deadly and a badass, so he's a good villain. But Captain Phasma is pathetic and boring and goes out like a wimp. Snoke was over the top evil, but the movie never fully committed to showing us his power or making him a badass, and now he's dead. That's why most people wanted to see more of Snoke, because he was the only legitimately committed villain in the whole movie. And Hux. Ooh, this. He has to be the most overacted. How come no one has said anything about this actor? Nobody talks about him. Nobody. I can't make it through this guy's performance without wanting to slit my wrists.
Win.
How come nobody is stopping him? He is by far the most insufferable thing in these last two movies. His acting is laughable. His delivery is garbage. There's nothing redeeming about his character. Is he unlikable? Yes, but not for the reasons he should be. He's awful, and not even a little badass. I think that's my main problem with these villains. They're all pussies. I can live with Kylo being a bit of a pussy, because that's sort of like what he's meant to be, but when 3/4 of your villains are pussies, and the other 1/4 is dead, you have messed up. But back on track. You want to see the Force be used in new and interesting ways, huh? How about Princess Leia just force pull herself through space while unconscious in fucking space? Where, how, and when did Leia learn to use the Force? I don't know. How come no one else has ever done that before? You know, like the whole pulling through space thing? I don't know. Why does Leia not use these Force powers at any other time? Oh, and here's just a literal ton of more horrible ideas and moments. Like 25 minutes of this casino planet rivaling the prequels. This girl who should have been replaced with Poe Dameron. A forced romance that no one cares about. This guy who should have been Lando but instead is just a goofball. Oh, and let's not forget about the late Carrie Fisher's, or Princess Leia's, what we assume to be corpse, dangling through space like a damn marionette puppet. Every interaction between Poe Dameron and this metaphor for Kathleen Kennedy. The weird and kind of rapey thing going on between Kylo and Rey. Luke drinking space cow titty milk, directly from space cow titties. Focus shot of space cow titties. Weird ass thing where they had this kid with force powers and it didn't really add up or mean anything. Oh yeah, and space cow titties. See, while one third of this movie delivered pretty much everything I wanted to see from a Star Wars movie, the other two thirds of this movie has to be some of the worst things I've ever seen. It's like Rian Johnson was taking bets. Fucking bets for what he could put in this movie. Well, you couldn't leave well enough alone, could ya, you son of a bitch? Oh! And that line at the end, where Poe was like, "Hey Rey, I'm Poe. We haven't met before. Tee hee hee. I hate you." I just needed to let that out. I think I just unblocked my chakras or something. But here's my fear, though. Because so many risks were taken with Episode 8, and because audiences hated it, Disney is probably going to take the message that risks are bad, and is just going to lump everything in The Last Jedi together, even the truly brilliant stuff that was enjoyable, and throw it all in the garbage for a by-the-numbers boring movie. Episode 9 is in deep trouble. It was thematic risks that got the story into the poor place it's currently in, and I think the only way to fix the story is to take more risks. If someone who works at Disney is by some chance watching this, please know that audiences still want to be challenged, but just challenged with good stuff. That while the bad stuff in The Last Jedi was a result of risks, the brilliant stuff was also a result of said risks. Now, if we're going to talk about what can be done to make Episode 9 good, I do want to make that video someday. Once I get this all out of my head, I think I'll be ready to come back to making videos normally. If you liked this video, please like it, share it with all your friends, subscribe to my YouTube channel for more content, and I think that's everything. I'll see you next time.